Thanks for joining us in Week News this morning on WXCW. We still have another hour of news ahead of us.
And right now, anchors Trace O'Shea and Sean Kreisman are ready to continue our coverage by letting us know what's coming up at 9.
Yeah, good morning, Robin, Jen. Good morning, Southwest Florida. Here they go. The first votes being cast in the Wisconsin primary. Polls opened just an hour ago. They'll close tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern time. A lot at stake for both Republicans and Democrats today.
Plus, locally, at least for the time being, Cape Coral bar hours return to normal, but we could see the city council try again in the future. We'll explain that to you ahead on Week News this morning.
Live from Southwest Florida's news leader, this is Week News this morning.
Good morning. Thank you for joining us for the 9 o'clock hour of Week News this morning here on WXCW. I'm Therese O'Shea.
And I'm Sean Kreisman. A lot to get to in the next hour, but first, some of the best video and sound from overnight and this morning in your Week News eye opener.
Now this morning is an ongoing investigation at the scene of a mobile home fire from overnight in North Fort Myers.
The North Fort Myers Fire Department tells me they got a call around 3 o'clock this morning. There were smoke and flames showing when they arrived on scene out here. They are considering it suspicious.
Police want your help so they can find this man here. Police say may have approached a young girl as she was walking to school in Immokalee. The girl is saying this guy asked if she wanted a ride. She kept walking and saying no.
I supported 4AM. I didn't support taxpayers paying for the additional police.
It looks like the late night partying in Cape Coral is over. A motion to reconsider the pilot program for those late night bar hours failed.
No matter who you are, a man or a woman, he treats everyone equal.
We have millions more votes than Cruz. We've beaten him in most of the states.
It's a big day for the race for the White House on the Republican side. 42 delegates up for grabs. A win by Ted Cruz today will increase the chances of a contested GOP convention in July. The world is becoming more militarized. Global spending is up more than $1.5 trillion just this year alone. It is the first increase in several years. The United States leads the world in defense spending with about $600 billion, with China a far second place at just an estimated $215 billion.
Britain, France, Australia, Mexico are all investigating their leaders for possible tax evasion because of the so-called Panama Papers data leak, and it accuses them of using offshore accounts to avoid paying taxes at home. The report's been causing protests around the world.
Midcourt, Jenkins gives it to Jenkins for the championship.
One of the closest championship games in sports history is Villanova's Chris Jenkins nailing a buzzer-beating three-pointer to win the national championship.
And that's your Wink News This Morning eye-opener.
Breaking news at 9. Right now we have an update to some breaking news we've been following all morning long for you.
A mobile home catching fire early this morning off of Epson Drive in North Fort Myers. That's where we find Wink News reporter Stephanie Suskind. She's live with the very latest. Good morning.
Good morning. The scene completely clear now. In fact, it's hard to even tell which mobile home caught on fire, but it is the front one, Unit G, that caught fire around 3 o'clock this morning. This fire is considered suspicious, and the state fire marshal was out here for hours this morning investigating. So while the scene is clear, the investigation certainly ongoing at this hour. Wink News has been here all morning long. The North Fort Myers Fire Department responded around 3 o'clock. They say there were smoke and flames coming from the kitchen. Now, they call this fire suspicious because they say they believe it may have actually started outside the home. There were two people there at the time inside the mobile home. They both got out safely, so no injuries associated with this. But again, a suspicious fire, so that's why they called in the state fire marshal to investigate. The Lee County Sheriff's Office also was on scene all morning long. They just took that crime scene tape down within the past hour, and now their investigation will continue. So, of course, you can count on Wake News to bring you any new information as we learn it about what caused this fire. Reporting in North Fort Myers, Stephanie Suskind, Wink News This Morning.
What a beautiful day, Southwest Florida. Look at this. We will talk about rain chances in the 7 day when I return.
Some new video into the Wink Newsroom. Fort Myers police say they heard shots in the area around of Veronica Shoemaker Boulevard and B Street. This happened just before 2 a.m. You could see officers standing outside the home at that corner of that intersection there, as well as walking around the back of the home. Now, at this point, we don't know if anyone was hurt. We are working with Fort Myers police to find out more information.
All new on Wink, the Northport Police Department needs your help. Early this morning, police sent Wink News some pictures of motorcycles. You see them right here. One of them was badly damaged. A crash involving two of them happened on Monday afternoon in the 2700 block of Panacea Boulevard, killing one of the drivers, 20-year-old Xavier Alonso. The second motorcycle driver, 23-year-old Hector Sanchez was taken to the Northport ER for his injuries. Police are looking for information about this biker group, saying they were seen traveling north between 4 and 4:15 Monday afternoon. If you have any information, please contact the Northport Police Department. Right now, police in the Panhandle are looking for two inmates who escaped from a private transport van early Monday morning. They're 30-year-old Michael Rotano and 31-year-old James Thomas Banks. The inmates were on their way from California and Texas to a facility in Jackson, Minnesota. Rotano is charged with larceny in a building and delivering and manufacturing narcotics. Banks faces charges of unarmed robbery and escaping from jail. The Walton County Sheriff's Office believes they're getting around in a stolen vehicle.
A second attempt at keeping Cape Coral bars open until 4 a.m. has failed. Cape councilors split the vote, so at least for this weekend, bars in the Cape will close at 2 a.m., but that doesn't mean we won't see this happen again. Week News anchor Jen Stacy, she's live in the studio to explain more.
Yeah, Sean, first of all, dozens upon dozens of people packed into the Cape Coral City Hall for this vote. Now, the majority of them were for longer bar hours, but council went another way. For a lot of people in the Cape, it's more than just two extra hours, and many walked out of council chambers devastated. Now, last week, Councilwoman Jessica Cosdins voted against extending the bar hours pilot program. Then she filed a motion to reconsider, which failed Monday night. For well over an hour, dozens of people from the community begged council to either reconsider the vote or put a stop to the late bar hours altogether. There were still many saying that longer hours are needed, including Councilman Jim Birch.
There is absolutely a very legitimate reason for saying we don't want bars from 2 to 4 in the morning.
People aren't down there to drink and just get drunk and be disorderly. They're down there because they want to see people. They want to be with other people.
Councilman Richard Leon tells Week News that he now plans to draft a new longer bar hours ordinance and then present that to council. Of course, count on Week News to let you know when that happens and what comes out of that decision.
On New this morning, a boat registered to Florida State Senator David Simmons crashed into a dock early this morning on Lake Maitland. That's in central Florida. You're seeing brand new video just into our newsroom. According to police, three people are in the hospital as trauma alert patients right now. It is not known if Simmons was on board. Reportedly, there was one adult, seven children, including teens, on the Sea-Doo Sport boat when it crashed. Officials say it's likely the boat was traveling at high speeds. They are looking into the possibility alcohol was involved.
Primary voters head to the polls in Wisconsin today to decide who should be their party's presidential nominee. Now, polls have been open for a little more than an hour already. On the Republican side, 42 delegates are up for grabs. For Democrats, 86 delegates are at stake. And as Week News reporter Don Champion tells us, the latest polls are spelling trouble for both frontrunners.
On the eve of the critical Wisconsin primary, Ted Cruz reminded supporters.
Don Champion, Week News Now.
So polls close in Wisconsin at 9 o'clock Eastern time tonight. Clinton and Sanders have agreed to debate each other next week in New York, which holds its primary April 19th. So we want to give you the delegate breakdown this morning. For the Republicans, Donald Trump right now has 736 delegates. Ted Cruz has 463, and John Kasich has 143. 1,237 delegates are needed for the nomination. Wisconsin has 42 up for grabs. Now for the Democrats, Hillary Clinton with her superdelegates has won 1,712 delegates. She's way ahead still of 1,011 rather that Bernie Sanders has. The Democrats need 2,383 to get the nomination.
And happening now, the Sanibel City Council is meeting to decide on a couple of pretty big issues here. For starters, the council will hold a discussion of the Civic Core. Here's what they want to do. They want to build a town center around the library and City Hall. They also want to upgrade the big arts facility. A tax increase is being discussed to pay for it. Also at the meeting, the council will ask to approve $155,000 of tourism development, council grant money to repair the fishing pier. Another interesting note, the council will vote on spending $20,000 on the Sanibel fireworks display for 4th of July. The annual July 4th parade on Fort Myers Beach, though, might have a new route this year. That's because of the old route that's under construction, and county leaders say it could be dangerous for spectators. Now the county is suggesting a shorter route. Some neighbors say it would hurt businesses the parade normally passes by. The parade route is expected to be approved in 2 weeks.
Today, Drew Steele, the host of Daybreak on 92.5 Fox News Radio, is holding a town hall meeting on the Lake Okeechobee water releases. It will focus on the history of the issue, the current status, and what's being done to alleviate what many see as damaging water flows. It's happening tonight at the City Pier Building in the Fort Myers River District. Doors open at 6:30. The town hall itself starts at 7. Speakers include State Senator Elizabeth Benequisto, State Representative Matt Caldwell, Lee County Commissioner Brian Hammond, Santa Mel Mayor Kevin Ruan, and John Campbell from the Army Corps of Engineers. And now on Wink, a huge victory for the Villanova Wildcats. It was a tie game till the bitter end, but they beat the North Carolina Tar Heels in the NCAA championship.
And this is the team's first title in 31 years. If you were watching, you know it was an intense game. Many people are calling it one of the greatest NCAA title games of all time. The big moment was the buzzer beater for victory with less than 5 seconds left. North Carolina tied the game with a three-pointer, but it wasn't enough. Villanova got the ball down court and scored as this horn was sounding.
Wow.
Final score, 77-74.
To get a buzzer beater in the championship game is a crazy thing. Okay, so Villanova University fans, of course, celebrated in the streets following their team's NCAA title win. They chanted and lit bonfires near the campus. A few fans, though, as expected, got out of hand. Authorities say at least 8 people were arrested. More than 30 others were injured, but none had any serious injuries. People get a little rowdy, you know, when they care so much about their team.
They like their sports, absolutely.
Wow.
Big win to Villanova. Did some of the world's most powerful people hide their wealth from tax collectors? Around the world, the fallout continues from an unprecedented financial leak. The latest on the Panama Papers coming up.
Well, high pressure building in. That means warmer temperatures already in the upper 60s southwest Florida. We'll talk about mid-80s when Wink News continues.
What price are you willing to pay to get your online life back? Coming up, Wink News investigates a new way for hackers to hold your information hostage and what the ransom might cost you to get it back. Time now is 9:12. Welcome back, pizza lovers. It's not too early to think about pizza because it is your day. Today is National Deep Dish Pizza Day. Now, that is not to be confused with regular National Pizza Day because that one was in February. We already celebrated it, despite the fact that I like to celebrate pizza day daily. Deep dish pizza, also known as Chicago style pizza, is made with a buttery crust that can be as high as 3 inches tall. So enjoy a slice today. I don't know that you can call deep dish pizza a slice. It's like its own cake, I feel like. I mean, you just dig in.
I don't like this kind of pizza.
I hate to, you know, not have any objectivity here, but I'm with you because I'm from New Jersey, so we're used to New York style, which is a lot thinner.
It's just all that bread. It's like a cake.
Like, hello, carbs. Yeah.
That's why they
so
call it pie. Yeah. That looks like a real pie.
Right.
Thank you, Eric. Put me in my place. That's what I call it pie, Sean.
But you know, what? I'm with you, both of you. I like the thin crust. I grew up in New Jersey, New Hampshire.
Yeah. So you get it.
I like that, too. So, hey, you know what? We get some great weather out there, right?
Enjoy.
But Monday afternoon, back to 83 degrees.
All right, it's that time of year, time for spring cleaning. No one really wants to do it, but if you're going to do it, you want to make sure it's as simple as possible.
Always. So where's Wink Now? Wink News reporter John Treweiler is live at 9 showing us how fun spring cleaning really can be with just a little bit of help, John.
Hey, good morning to you, Therese and Sean. We're at the Home Depot this morning. Yeah, spring cleaning, we've showed you some great tips this morning.
We want to feature your nonprofit organization, special fundraising event, or unique attraction in our Where's Wink Now segment in the morning.
It's easy to do. Send us an email to thismorning@winknews.com and tell us what's going on. We'll have some fun with you, share some good news about what's happening in our entire community. It's 9:20. You're watching Wink News This Morning. Welcome back this morning. We're learning more about a massive document leak out of Panama. Britain, France, Australia, and Mexico all starting up large-scale investigations of their leaders for possible tax evasion. Some are calling this the WikiLeaks of the mega-rich. The so-called Panama Papers suggest Panama law firm Mossack Fonseca helped establish secret shell companies and offshore accounts for at least 140 politicians, public officials around the world. Now, the accounts themselves, they're not actually illegal, but journalists who have seen these documents say the leak reveals money laundering schemes, sanctions busting deals, and other crimes.
the same system that politicians and the mega wealthy and billionaires are using to move money and do transactions is also being used by criminals, drug kingpins.
And with journalists still poring over mountains of data, there may be more revelations to follow.
Right now, an important consumer alert for you and your family. Authorities are warning about a growing scam called ransomware. Hackers disable personal computers and even entire networks, then demand a ransom to give the users their files back. Now, as Wink News reporter DeMarco Morgan explains, everyone from consumers to business owners are getting targeted.
Plainfield, New Jersey, a town of roughly 50,000 people.
DeMarco Morgan, CBS News, New York.
Experts say it is important to avoid clicking on suspicious links that can allow hackers into your computer. You should also always back up your files. Some good advice. Also this morning, we have an interesting story. I want to listen to this. So the iPhone is about to hit a big landmark. Apple is expected to sell its 1 billionth iPhone this summer. The gadget made its debut just back in June of 2007, really not that long ago. By the end of last year, Apple said it had roughly sold about 896 million. The new iPhone SE is scheduled to come out soon, and that's expected to give Apple another boost in sales. Analysts say if current trends continue, Apple will sell its 2 billionth iPhone by the end of the decade.
Two iPhone users
Whoa,
here.
Oh, yeah, so. And I'm not ready to upgrade
you
yet.
You want to hear something crazy? The iPhone 7 should be announced by the end of the year.
Oh, my goodness.
Forget the SE.
You know, you feel good about yourself with your new iPhone for all of 2 months, and then there's something to replace it.
Oh. I know. All right, coming up at 9:30 on Wink News this morning, how many unsolved murders are there in Lee County? Well, one group says only about 50% of those cases are closed. The Lee County Sheriff's Office says that's way off.
Plus, Wink News is live on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. Here's a live look out there right now as the opening bell is going to ring in less than 3 minutes. We have today's business headlines and how they affect you coming up.
Welcome back. It's 9:30 at the New York Stock Exchange. Opening bell just rang.
Let's check in with Wink News Money Watch reporter Jill Wagner. She's live at the Stock Exchange with our business news. Good morning, Jill.
Good morning, Trace and Sean. Twitter users, are you ready for some football? Twitter won the rights to stream NFL games online on Thursday nights. It's not known how much Twitter paid, but Verizon and Yahoo and Amazon.com were also reportedly interested. Alaska Air is buying Virgin America for $2.6 billion. This creates the country's fifth largest airline. What does this mean for travelers? It's a little too soon to tell, but analysts say more consolidation in the industry means fewer bargains. Although this new merged company would compete with bigger airlines like United and Delta, and that could force them to lower prices. We'll see. All right, here in Wall Street, the opening bell just rang. Looking at the big board right now, the Dow is down about 80 points. So we'll see if things could turn around for the rest of the day. It's Race and Chung.
All right, we'll keep monitoring that. Jill, though, I'm sure a lot of people can relate to this, to need to take a nap in the afternoon. I do it myself. But we hear Spain may soon put an end to their beloved siestas.
That's right. Spain's prime minister announced a plan to get rid of the Spanish siesta. It's a 3-hour midday break from work. So this plan means that Spain would end its work days at 6 p.m. instead of what it currently does, which is ended at 8 p.m. And that would align Spain with the rest of Europe. Therese and Sean.
I guess that makes it sense, more of the normal 9 to 6, whatever they are these days, kind of hours. But a 3-hour nap or rest or break in the middle of the day, that sounds great.
Sounds lovely, right?
Yeah. A little bottle of vino there in Spain, a little siesta.
Good times.
I wouldn't want to go back to work.
That's
when
the
you
problem.
Put it that way.
Yeah.
That is true.
Very
that is true. Nothing ever gets done. All right, Jill Wagner live in New York. No. Good to talk to you this morning. Have a good one. All right, let's check on that weather right now. Is it a sunny one, Eric? Has
sure it? Is. Gorgeous outside. In fact, sunny sky today with low humidity, dew points in the 50s. But we will talk about rain chances in the 7-day coming up.
Now this morning, an interfaith group is demanding action amid growing concern over safety in Southwest Florida. The group says there are too many unsolved murders right here in Lee County, and more specifically, Fort Myers. Wink News anchor Rob Spicker joins us live in the studio with more information. Rob, are they saying just how many unsolved murders there are?
They do have a large number, John, and that's what they're worried about. This is from the interfaith meeting, and we learned from them January 2010 through January 2015, they're claiming 185 murders in Lee County and just 92 arrests. That comes from the Lee Interfaith for Empowerment. It's a coalition of 15 congregations. It's also known as LIFE. The group says that Fort Myers' murder-to-arrest rate is very low, at just 36% for that same period in the city. However, the sheriff's office is saying the numbers are wrong. They're saying the Lee County arrest rate is at 75%. Fort Myers Police Chief Dennis Eads, he agrees his department's numbers are lower than he would like them to be. But he says he's going to need your help to solve cases. Witnesses have got to come forward. But the Reverend Dr. William Glover is saying law enforcement needs to stop blaming their community and try to solve these cases.
We have to get a grip on this problem, and it starts with criminals being held account. If they are not arrested, they are emboldened, and they are brash, and they are bold, and they will continue their actions.
Chief Eads has agreed he'll look into other ways that the department could clear more of its open cases. Says he's also going to try to work better with the Attorney General's office and also give the Life Group quarterly progress updates. Sean, back to you.
Rob, thank you. A lot of big stories happening today around the country. In Alabama, Governor Robert Bentley may be one step closer to impeachment. A state lawmaker is expected to announce his intent today to file a resolution containing articles of impeachment. A second-term Republican Governor Bentley is accused of having an inappropriate relationship with a former staffer. He's denied the relationship was sexual. He's also said he was truly sorry, accepted full responsibility, though he is rejecting calls for him to step down. Moving on to Missouri. In the city of Ferguson today, people there will vote on whether to raise sales and property taxes. Now, the passage of those taxes, that is crucial to pay for the implementation of a settlement with the U.S. Justice Department. An examination by the Justice Department after Officer Darren Wilson shot and killed Michael Brown uncovered significant racial bias in Ferguson's criminal justice system. City leaders say measures associated with the agreement will cost Ferguson $2.3 million. That's over 3 years. The mayor says that number is impossible to meet without raising taxes in the area. Out on the West Coast now, the San Francisco Board of Supervisors is voting today on whether to require 6 weeks of fully paid leave for new parents. This move would be a first for any jurisdiction. The state already allows workers to receive 55% of their pay for up to 6 weeks to bond with a new child. The money comes out of a state insurance program funded by workers. And of course, this new proposal would require those San Francisco employers with at least 20 employees to make up the rest.
Federal fishing regulators are hoping to crack down on illegal fishing imports. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration supports changes that would create a new system to collect data about commercial fishing catch and fish imports into the U.S. The information collected under the new standards would help authorities verify imported fish was lawfully acquired. Public comment period on proposed new rules closes today. And got on camera for you this morning, a crazy moment. You see right here, the video is starting.
Yeah, this is bad weather. As if you keep watching this video as we're taking on the street, right there, tree goes down. And if you're wondering where it is, it's Boonton Township, New Jersey. That led to a large tree snapping and falling right in front of an oncoming pickup truck. The police car that happened to catch this on video was heading to another traffic call. The truck hit the tree, briefly traveled airborne before coming to its final resting place on top of the tree. Thankfully, though, happy to report no one was injured.
Thank goodness. It looks like a scene out of a movie.
Yeah.
Well, coming up on Week News this morning, right after the break, a truly touching story of an elderly cancer patient getting to meet the 25-year-old who saved his life. You don't want to miss this one.
Plus, Backstreet is back. The heartthrobs of the 90s are making a play to entertain in Sin City. We'll explain the details ahead in the Week News Flash. It's 9:37. You're watching Week News this morning. Welcome back to Week News this morning. Now, this next story would really warm your heart.
An Oklahoma City man is being called a hero after donating bone marrow to a sick man. Now, normally donors and recipients don't know each other, but the two had a rare opportunity to actually meet up.
And Week News reporter Gant Herms was there for the very emotional exchange.
It was unnerving.
When Graham Bowen was diagnosed with leukemia.
And I feel the same about him. I feel like he's part of my family now.
Giving a whole new meaning to related by blood.
You know, I've got to figure out what I'm going to do for the next 20 years.
Now, Graham is one of the oldest recipients for this procedure in the country. And the great news is that his cancer is in full remission. Can you believe that?
Yeah, it's a great story there. Cancer's no joke, and to have a good result like that, not everyone gets that. So
no, not everyone steps up to help, too. Yeah. Coming up right after the break, get your most accurate weather forecast with Week News meteorologist Eric Stone.
And plus the Week News Flash, all today's headlines and more. You're watching Week News This Morning on WXCW.
Well, some nights I wish that this all would end, 'cause I could
back. Live look there at the Southwest Florida Eagle Camp. Always good to check up on our local Eagles.
They're growing up.
They're
so big now.
The little eaglets getting much bigger.
Time is going by.
That's so great that both of them are doing well.
I know. Health-wise, you could see outside, too, with that live look at the Eagle Cam, that it's sunny. It looks beautiful.
We got the sunshine in the Sunshine State. That's where it belongs, right?
That's right.
55 degrees, but Monday, your high is 83.
It's time for the Wink News Flash. All of today's headlines from the world of news, sports, entertainment, and more.
And we're going to start you right here in Southwest Florida, where the state fire marshal just wrapped up in the last hour an investigation into a suspicious mobile home fire in North Fort Myers. Wink News reporter Stephanie Susskind has the very latest.
The scene is now clear, but the investigation is ongoing into what caused the fire at this mobile home early this morning. It was around 3 o'clock when the fire department responded. And we just spoke to a neighbor out here who says he was actually pouring buckets of water on the fire, trying to help put it out. He also says he spotted a gas can near the fire. Now, the North Fort Myers Fire Department does call this a suspicious fire. That's why they called in the state fire marshal to help with the investigation. The fire marshal on scene early this morning. They say the fire was contained to the kitchen area, but they do think it may have started outside the trailer, and that's another reason why they are considering it suspicious. The Lee County Sheriff's Office was also on scene throughout the morning, but they have now taken down the crime scene tape and cleared the scene. So Wink News will continue to ask questions about what caused this fire and what led up to all of this. Of course, count on updates as soon as we get them. Reporting in North Fort Myers, Stephanie Susskind, Wink News this morning.
We continue the Wink News Flash with a look at this morning's top stories. Brand new information just into the Wink Newsroom about a home invasion in Cape Coral.
And take a look. This was the scene at the 900 block Southeast 27th Terrace overnight. Cape police say they responded to a call of shots fired around 9 p.m. And people in the neighborhood heard gunshots. They saw several people with flashlights trying to break into a home. Investigators say two armed men who the victim knew demanded money owed to them. The two suspects, they left the house firing several gunshots at the victim's car as they left. The investigation, that's still ongoing.
Cape Coral extended bar hours will likely be back up for debate again. Councilman Richard Leon says he's going to draft an ordinance to move bar hours, closing hours in the entertainment district back to 4 a.m. The proposal to reconsider last week's decision moving closing time back to 2 a.m. failed. Police say for the longer hours to work, they need to have more officers on duty. And finding a way to pay for them right now is what the problem is.
Today, Drew Steele, the host of Daybreak on 92.5 Fox News Radio, he's holding a town hall meeting on the Lake Okeechobee water release. It will focus on the history of the issue, the current status, and what is being done to alleviate what many see as the damaging water flows. It's happening tonight at the City Pier Building in the Fort Myers River District. Doors open at 6:30. The town hall starts at 7.
Primary voters have started voting today in Wisconsin's primary. On the Republican side, 42 delegates are up for grabs. For the Democrats, 86 delegates are at stake. The latest tracker poll has Ted Cruz 6 points ahead of GOP frontrunner Donald Trump, but both candidates are calling for John Kasich to drop out of the race. Democrat Hillary Clinton all but conceded Wisconsin to Bernie Sanders. Still, the two candidates remain locked in a virtual tie.
In your entertainment headlines this morning, the Walt Disney Company is searching for a new successor to their CEO after Tom Staggs announced that he is leaving the company next month. The current CEO, Bob Iger, was stepped down in June 2018. Now, Staggs is Disney's chief operating officer. He served in different roles for the last 26 years, rising in the ranks and the assumed heir apparent to Iger. Staggs played a critical part in Disney's purchases of Pixar and Marvel. He also began leading the Parks and Resort unit in 2010. Disney says it will now broaden its candidate search. Star Wars The Force Awakens is available on Blu-ray and DVD today. It became available on digital download April 1st, though. There are a ton of special features, guys, on Blu-ray. A behind-the-scenes documentary, deleted scenes, commentary, and even the audition tapes of Daisy Ridley and John Boyega. Batman will battle more than Superman this year with the upcoming Batman the Killing Joke. The animated movie is based on the iconic 1988 graphic novel. This is a little darker than your typical superhero movie, something many Batman fans will be happy to hear. The film stars the voices from Batman the Animated Series, including Kevin Conroy as the Caped Crusader and Mark Hamill as the Joker. It will be released on DVD later this year. Okay, watch out, Elvis impersonators, J-Lo and Britney. Here comes, yeah, the Backstreet Boys. The boy band has inked a deal for a trial run of shows in Las Vegas. According to member Nick Carter, the group has a deal for 9 shows in Sin City. These performances are part of an upcoming worldwide tour. Carter also says the Backstreet Boys are working on a new album. No word on a release date yet, Therese, but we'll watch out for that. Well, are they Backstreet Men now?
They are Backstreet Men, pretty much like NSYNC is NSYNC.
You got to change it.
Men, you're right. All right, there really is only one sports headline this morning. The Villanova Wildcats are champions of college basketball. You see the celebrations right here. The end of the game between the Wildcats and North Carolina truly gives credence to the phrase March Madness.
Villanova trying to go length of the court with Archie Diacono. 3 seconds at midcourt.
Well, Jenkins
gives it to Jenkins for the championship.
And there it is, Chris Jenkins with a 3-point buzzer beater for the championship. That shot came after a clutch three from North Carolina to tie it up, but Villanova ultimately wins. Now here's a fun note about Chris Jenkins. His brother, Nate Britt, actually plays for the Tar Heels. Britt's family adopted him in 2007. And now, in the words of Nate Britt, his brother will have bragging rights for life. Pretty cool for them. How about another championship game to talk about for you this morning? The U.S. women's hockey team are gold medal winners, beating Canada in the Women's World Hockey Championship. That game was scoreless into overtime when Alex Carpenter gets one into the net 12 and a half minutes into OT. The U.S. went undefeated en route to its third straight World Championship gold. The U.S. and Canada have met in every final of the 17 Women's World Championships. Canada won the first date, but the balance of power has swung south of the border with the U.S., now taking 7 of the last 9. Russia downed Finland 1-0 in a shootout for the bronze medal. Now, football fans, you could see something happen in 2016's NFL season that has not happened since 1990, the expansion of the postseason. During a meeting with Jaguars season ticket holders, NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell said the league will likely expand the playoffs in the future. In 1990, the playoffs jumped from 10 spots to the current number of 12. The next expansion would likely be 14 teams. Goodell didn't give a timeline for changes, but we should note the expanding playoffs has been on his agenda since 2012. So maybe
there's a lot of other things going on with the NFL besides this one, so
a little more drama.
Yeah.
All right, trending now in the week news flash, a woman in New Zealand just broke the Guinness World Record for the highest static trapeze act.
Yeah, check her out. We're going to show you. There she is. That is Anne Cochran. She performed this trapeze act of a height of 10,365 feet. As you can see, she is dangling from a hot air balloon. Anna suffered a dislocated rib only a couple of minutes into the challenging routine, but the Pilates instructor didn't let it stop her from completing the 5-minute dance required to take home the Guinness World Records title.
So there's no net behind her, beneath her, rather.
I have to assume she is.
Is she on a wire? I have to assume
she's got to be hooked
this
in.
Makes
because
me
I mean,
very
this is,
nervous.
Yeah, it's very risky. Make
the
or break.
Maternal instincts in me are kicking in, saying that doesn't look safe.
By the way, she's fine. So,
good.
Yeah, a lot of talent there, but breaking the record. How about that?
Wow.
All right, you're watching Week News this morning on WXCW.
We're back in less than 3 minutes with your final forecast.